Today I'm sharing an easy recipe to prepare for celebrating the Chinese New Year. Hi, sweet friends. My name is Mary, and welcome to Mary's Nest. This channel is all about living the simple life by cooking from scratch, making home remedies from homegrown herbs and spices, and creating a cozy home with charming thrift store finds. So if you're like me and you like living the simple life, be sure to subscribe to my channel and click on the little notification bell that'll let you know every time I upload a new video. As I've shared with you in the past, my husband is of Asian ancestry, so we always enjoy celebrating Chinese New Year. And this year, he's requested a recipe that I enjoy making that involves rice noodles and salmon. I've got a beautiful side of sockeye salmon here, which I've just sprinkled with some salt, some black pepper, and some red pepper flakes. Now the rest of the ingredients that you're going to need to prepare this are a package of rice noodles and some vegetables of your choice. Here I've got snow peas, broccoli, and asparagus. And you're also going to want some green onions that I've just sliced up. And this is some fish stock. It's 4 cups of fish stock. And then for finishing things off, I've just got a little sesame oil, the toasted sesame oil, and some nuts. You can use any nuts you want, whatever you have on hand, just chopped up. Now what I'm going to do here is bring 3 quarts of water up to the boil, and then I'm going to put my rice noodles in, boil them for 3 minutes, and then drain them and toss them with a little bit of the sesame oil. Now I've removed these from the boiling water after 3 minutes, and I scooped them out, and I kept the water in there hot because that's the same water we'll use to cook the vegetables with. And now I'm just tossing these with a little bit, just a smidge of sesame oil, the toasted sesame oil, just so that they don't stick. And I'll keep them in this bowl and I'll set them aside. And then the next thing that I've done is I've started to heat my grill pan, and I'm gonna put this fish onto the grill pan, fish side down first, get some nice grill marks on it, then I'll flip it over, and let it finish cooking skin side down. Well, I flip my salmon over, and now I'm gonna let it cook a little longer with the skin side down, and then we'll get ready to continue with the vegetables. And in the interim, over here on the back burner, I'm warming my fish stock. Now you can make your own or you can buy it. If you don't have fish stock or fish broth, you can use chicken broth as well. I've done that sometimes and it comes quite nice. And so just the first time when I put the fish down, I just want to mention, when I put it fish side down, I had my grill pan preheated just on medium. And then when I flipped it over, in about 3 minutes or so on the fish side, and then when I flipped it over to the skin side, I turned the burner down just a little bit lower, about to medium low, and just to let it finish cooking. Well, I've got my water up to a boil. This is the same water that I used to cook the noodles in, so no need to empty and strain and all of that. Just scoop the noodles out as I did. And then what I'm gonna do now is, the vegetables I've got here are broccoli, snow peas, asparagus, and then I've got some green onions. I'm gonna put the broccoli and the asparagus in, and then for about 3 minutes, and then I'll add the snow peas in for another minute or two. And now I'm gonna add the snow peas for another minute. And we like to have our green onion cooked a little. You can also just sprinkle it on top as a garnish if you like it a little crunchy. But we like to cook it a little, so I'm gonna go ahead and add the green onion in at this point too. Well, I strained all the water out of my vegetables. I'm just gonna put those to the side for a minute, and I'll get ready to show you how we put this all together. Now, what I like to do is get a nice big bowl and scoop in a generous amount of the rice noodles. Then I just like to put some vegetables in. Any way is fine. And I'm just gonna arrange these all around. And then I'll show you how we'll put the salmon on. Then I just slice a piece of the salmon and put it on top of the veggies and the rice noodle. And then I take my fish broth and just pour a generous amount on top and all around, so that we've got the rice noodles floating in some lovely fish broth. And then, I did about 2 ladles full. I think I'll do another one, make it nice and a generous amount for my husband. And then I like to just take a few nuts for just a little extra crunch and sprinkle them on top. Not a lot, that's it. And then if you want, you can take a little extra sesame oil and drizzle it on top. Now we're ready to eat. If you'd like another fish recipe, be sure to subscribe to my channel and then click on this video over here where I show how to make a wonderful Italian fish stew. And I'll see you over there in my Texas Hill Country kitchen. Love and God bless.